Local fire departments are trying to fill the gaps to keep you and your family safe. Good evening to you and thank you for joining us. I'm Rondrell Moore. Out of the thousands of fire departments across the country, most of them are volunteers. That's according to national statistics. But as News 10's Aaliyah Blackburn explains, these departments are battling more than just the flames.
Ask any local volunteer fire department and they'll tell you the shortage has been around for years. As names age out and move on, filling the void only gets tougher. That's as many factors are contributing to a lack of interest in volunteering.
On the front lines of West Terre Haute is the Sugar Creek Fire Department.
Every third day when I come in for my 24-hour shift, I don't think of it as I'm going to work.
There we go.
Lieutenant Sam McLean is now one of three full-time firefighters, and volunteering is where it all started.
After my first couple runs, I was hooked.
However, stories like McLean's are rare these days. That's as departments continue to struggle to find more volunteers to add to the roster.
This is a job where they get a good education, where it's more of a community service type thing.
And some believe that could be part of the problem, throwing little to no compensation and other factors like time demands and training requirements. Lieutenant Samuel Stranahan says the drive to volunteer becomes less and less.
It's a stressful job on both mind and body, and we do what we can to try and keep people fresh in it.
For Sugar Creek, who has at least 40 people on their roster right now, they say they're doing pretty well. The department hosts outreach programs to neighboring high schools and colleges like Indiana State to draw interest.
If they want to come onto our roster and be trained as firemen or be trained as EMTs, that they can come and stay here and, you know, actively participate as a roster member.
So as older names move on, maybe new ones can come in, sparking a flame to help others and possibly even a lifelong career of their own.
I think I'd be stuck in a factory somewhere, you know, staring at one machine for 8 hours a day, but I really don't think I would trade what I'm doing right now for anything else in the world.
If you're interested in volunteer opportunities with Sugar Creek or the programs that you heard in the story, we have contact information for you on our website. That's WTHI-TV.com.